Hello there, very good morning to you. Well, today joining us is one of our proactive research analysts here, Daniel Appiah. Great to see you once again. And today we're discussing your report on SourceBio. You've said that they are reinvesting for post-COVID business. That's the title of your article. So thank you very much indeed. You're going to give us a bit more flavour as to what you've been analysing. Great to see you, Daniel. And if the audience do want to access that report, they certainly can do so by clicking on the eye in the corner of the screen. Now, I've had the pleasure of speaking to this firm a few times. I know that they're very keen to emphasise the fact that they're not just all about COVID, because of course, for them, it represented a huge opportunity. They were able to help people in that situation. Let's maybe just start, though, for the people that aren't quite so familiar with what the company do. What do they do, Daniel?
Sure. So SourceBio International, a UK-based company, and they provide clinical and drug development services for a range of different sorts of pharmaceutical companies, for the NHS and also for private healthcare providers. So the company itself is centered around three core business units, which are the health diagnostics business unit, which is primarily cellular pathology, the genomics business unit, which is consists of DNA sequencing for research and clinical discovery, and the stability storage business unit, which has storage and stability services for drug trials, servicing and validation of equipment for those drug trials, and also the manufacturing of said equipment. But over the last 2 years, given the COVID pandemic, which has been going on, they've also developed a non-core business unit in their infectious disease diagnostic testing unit, which has been administering PCR tests. And as I say, over the last 2 years, that's taken up the bulk of their business.
Maybe let's talk about some financials now in regards to their results for 2021 then.
Sure. So it's been another very strong year for them. So they're emerging from 2 years of a global pandemic in which infectious disease testing has dominated their sales revenue. And they saw explosive growth in that revenue stream from the second half of 2020 as the pandemic sort of got into full swing, and also as companies started to pivot and adapt to the new sort of testing landscape. So in 2020, their infectious disease testing unit generated $34.5 million in sales, around 40% profit margin. And in 2021, that went up to 73.6 at about similar sort of 39% profit margin. And by the end of 2021, they're running 2.1 million tests during that year. So a huge increase as we saw the Omicron wave start to come into the fore and the demand increase. So there's that, which has generated enormous cash for the company. They at the year end of last year, they had roughly $33.3 million in cash, and they're using that to invest into their core businesses.
Mm-hmm. All right, well, let's maybe talk about that in regards to what's next for the company. You mentioned investment there.
Yeah, so in terms of the underlying business units, they're actually very healthy. Although they saw a modest dip during the pandemic, the profitability has remained pretty stable. So genomics saw revenue increase in 2021, for example, of 17.6%. And this is despite the dip during the pandemic which ensued. And this is split primarily between the Sanger sequencing service they offer, which is sort of the gold standard in the genomics industry, and this next generation sequencing technology which they offer. This is increasingly becoming the next generation, that is increasingly becoming the lion's share of their genomics revenue. And that shows that the company is investing in future technologies and the ability for them to scale. They also have the stability and storage business unit, which is also doing very well. Although the revenues dipped very slightly in 2021, what you actually see is that the profit margins for that business unit are far outperforming the others. So the gross margin for stability storage is around 50%, and the genomics business unit is around 39%. So even though the sales have dipped slightly because of market forces, it is still going on very strong. However, what Source have said they want to do is pivot towards cellular pathology, because that's where they see there's going to be increased demand. As we emerge from the pandemic, there's an increase in demand from the people like the NHS as the backlog of elective surgeries comes to the fore, and the shortage of pathologists really starts to sort of make itself known in the public health industry. So this is why SourceBio have invested $18.5 million in buying LB Path Limited. And this is a digital cellular pathology play. So what they do is around 75% of their business is digital. They take these images of human tissue, they analyze them using technology, using pathologists. What's really exciting about this is really the future and what this could mean for SourceBio and the pathology industry in general. So what LDPath are wanting to do is use AI to analyze these images of human tissue. And that's a really interesting prospect, not just because of, you know, the scales which we could reach, but also because, as we said, we have a shortage of pathologists in this country. And what this AI technology could mean is that the AI can screen out the easiest cases and leave the hardest cases for the pathologist to really tackle. So they've invested in this new company to try and sort of push the cellular pathology line. However, it really, the profitability of that really hinges on whether the NHS market materializes, and also whether the NHS are really going to be adaptable to this new technology, which historically they've been quite slow to do.
Such an interesting company. Thank you so very much. That's Daniel Appiah here on Proactive London, talking through your report that you've compiled on SourceBio International. So thank you very much.